Atmospheric memory is inspired by an idea from the 19th century. In 1837, British inventor and polymath Charles Babbage said that as we speak, we create a turbulence in the air. And this fellow, the inventor of the very first computer, thought, what would happen if we can actually calculate the trajectory of all the molecules of air and then rewind them in such a way that we could recreate the voices of everyone who's spoken in the past? So atmospheric memory begins with this idea of Babbage's, that the atmosphere is a library, and then it takes it fast forward, say 180 years later, to think about, you know, can we create machines to actually make his dream a reality? Can we extract sound from the atmosphere? And crucially, if we could remember everything, would we want that? And the answer is, through the artwork, is that we are talking about the digital atmosphere, and the fact is that nowadays everything is recorded, and in fact, nothing is forgotten. All of our operations, our conversations, our credit card movements, our cell phone position, there are so many sensors around us that are recording everything that we do. And so, from a perspective of activism, the project asks, well, who has access to this information? And obviously the answer is a very small group of people. So I'm super excited to be here presenting the project, because a lot of this has been under development for a really long time, but it is not until the last moments that you put it together and you see the full scale. I think that the juxtaposition of pieces works really well. There's, for example, a sculpture, which is a 3D printed speech bubble made in steel, and it's something that people can touch and kind of have a sense for how fluid dynamic works, whereas other works are ephemeral. There's this enormous cloud display that writes whatever you speak into a microphone using cold water vapor, and your word is ephemeral and it disappears. So it's not just a juxtaposition in scale, also in time. You know, one is durable, one is impermanent. You're asking people not just to be sort of separated from reality, but brought back into reality and to think about our world in a different way. So when you come out of the project, I want people to be aware that the atmosphere is not neutral, is not invisible. On the one hand, it does carry our song, it carries our voice, and it makes us together, brings us together, gives us life. On the other hand, with this accumulation of carbon dioxide, the toxicity of cities like mine, Mexico City, is bringing on death on a yearly, on a daily basis. And so we need to be concerned about that. But as something that potentially is, might kill you, as well as communicate your most beautiful thoughts or the most beautiful song. So this kind of two possibilities of the atmosphere come through in the art.